Hi, I'm James from Raven Audio, and I'd like to tell you why you should audition a Raven Audio integrated tube amplifier. First, here are some interesting things to know about our integrated tube amplifier series called the Avians. There are three models: the Nighthawk, Blackhawk, and Osprey. The Nighthawk and Blackhawk are both 20 watts per channel, but the Blackhawk has our high-end audiophile capacitors, which we use in our elite amplifiers that cost over $50,000. These capacitors in the Blackhawk give it a deeper and wider soundstage. On the aesthetic side of things, the Nighthawk is space gray, while the Blackhawk and the Osprey are midnight charcoal, also known as black. Now, the third Avian, the Osprey, also has high-end capacitors, just like the Blackhawk, but has 50% more power at 30 watts per channel. The Nighthawk and Blackhawk are automatically biased, but the Osprey Mark 3.2 is now fully manually biased. No matter what anyone tells you, there is always a trade-off between automatically biased tube amplifiers and manually biased tube amplifiers. It's just physics. Therefore, we make both so that you have the choice. Biasing is not difficult, and if you choose an Osprey, we'll teach you how to bias it, and it'll hold its bias for many, many years. The Osprey is the amp that I have in my house and also in my audio suite where I mix and master classical music recordings. All three have five source inputs and one set of outputs that you can use to drive a subwoofer. But what is really cool is we have a high pass switch that, when engaged, relieves the tube power amplifier section from having to reproduce nearly as much low frequency content, which is what consumes most of any amplifier's power. This essentially doubles the effective power for mid-bass, mid-range, and high frequencies. Of course, you would only use this if you have a subwoofer. This is unique to Raven Audio. No one else out there has this feature. Now, let's talk a moment about the philosophy behind the design of the Avian Series amplifiers. Before I do that, I want you to know the key decision makers at Raven Audio all come from professional musicians and recording industry backgrounds, which is where music and sound begin. Dave Thompson, our founder, was a charted singer and professional musician for many years in the 80s and 90s, opening for singers like Willie Nelson, George Strait, George Jones, and Tanya Tucker, just to name a few. I studied violin since I was a small child and up through college, and have been a professional recording producer and engineer for over 30 years, working with world-class classical musicians. Our chairman of the board of advisors for Raven Audio for many years, until his recent passing, was Bill Vorndick. Bill had over 40 albums nominated for Grammy Awards and won many Grammys. He produced and engineered albums for the biggest names in the music business. Just Google him. I tell you all of this not to brag, but because I want you to understand who we are and where we're coming from, and that our passion in life is music and sound. Dave and I have spent our lifetimes listening to great musicians practice, perform, and record. I've spent thousands of hours in and around orchestras, choirs, and ensembles, where there are no microphones or sound systems, only the real instruments and the acoustics of the concert hall. We know what real pianos, violins, brass instruments, acoustic guitars, and the voices of many different singers actually sound like in person, with no microphones, speakers, or amplifiers in the equation. Dave has stood a few feet, many times, from George Strait, Willie Nelson, and other famous singers while they've practiced or warmed up. I was extremely lucky to get to hear Luciano Pavarotti sing without amplification, less than 20 feet away from me, on several occasions. His voice directly to my ears. These sonic imprints in our minds guide our designs and voicing of our amplifiers and speakers. For us, it's 100% about the sound and not about the specifications. We want you to experience the emotional and visceral impact of music when using a Raven amplifier, just as we do. The initial design criterion of the Avian Series amplifiers was first that they have to be the best sounding amplifier in the industry at anywhere even near close the price range or double. This was achieved with years of experimentation and voicing of various designs. Second, they are designed to be solid and reliable for a lifetime. They are not like a computer or DAC that become obsolete every few years. They will continue to give and nurture your musical experiences for a lifetime. In fact, we have a 45-day in-home trial with minimal cost to you so that you can experience everything that I've just described. We sell hundreds of these amplifiers per year, and it's extremely rare for someone to send one back during the 45-day trial period. Go read what other owners of Raven Audio amplifiers are saying on the forums. There's a third part of Dave's design criterion which supports the previous two that I've described. Don't be all things to all people and therefore be a master of none. What does that mean? Well, one example is the Avian amplifiers only use one type of power tube, which is key to their superior sound. As it turns out, the 6L6GC was best suited for the sound that Dave was aiming for. Once that was determined, after several years of trials and experimentation, all of the circuitry in the amplifier was designed and built around this one tube. I'll also say that the lack of circuitry and clutter in these amplifiers are due to this one type of power tube only design. You see, if an amplifier can accommodate three or four different types of power tubes, then the power transformer must be 3 to 4 times larger and more complicated to supply the voltages to those different types of tubes. There will be 3 to 4 times more wiring coming from the transformer to the rest of the amplifier. And there will be additional switching circuitry to detect which tube is being used and switch to the correct power tap from the transformer. If this all sounds very complicated, it is, and results in a lot more stuff being crammed inside the amplifier chassis. Less ventilation, less sound purity, and much more chance for something to break. One of the lessons that we've learned over the years is that simplicity is a key ingredient in creating the best sounding amplifiers. Our good friend Nelson Pass once told me that his favorite amplifier designs are around the 30 watt power range because of what you can do in terms of simplicity and the trade-offs that you don't have to make in a more complicated design. Another industry leader, Jam Sumasundaram, a power transformer designer, feels that simplicity is essential in achieving the best sound quality. Jam designed our grounding circuitry and contributed to the design of our toroidal power transformer, which together yield one of the quietest noise floors of any tube amplifier in the industry. These power transformers and grounding circuits are new with the Avian Mark 3.2 series of the Nighthawk, Blackhawk, and Osprey. There's another point that we are very proud of, and I would like for you to be aware of it. Our amplifiers are made in America. We feel very strongly about this for three reasons. First, it's necessary to get the quality and reliability that Raven amplifiers have. Dave and I have to be able to personally inspect every step of the manufacturing process, and we do that regularly. Secondly, we will not work in countries like China that systematically steal intellectual property from their customers. And thirdly, we believe in supporting America and Americans. So, what does made in America really mean? I'll be specific. The metal chassis is made and powder coated at All Metals in Dallas, Texas. The PC boards are made at ARQ in College Station, Texas, which makes PC boards for NASA. Our custom toroidal power transformers and output transformers are made in Minnesota. Are there any components made in other countries? Yes. The volume control and the input select are made by Alps and are manufactured in Japan. Some of the resistors and capacitors are made in Japan, Germany, Spain, and even England. The input RCA connectors are made by a German company, Neutrik, who makes 99% of the connectors found in the world's best recording studios. On the whole, very little of what is in our amplifiers is made outside of the United States. Let's take a look inside of one. You'll see that there is about a 50-50 combination of PC board and hand wiring. We choose to hand wire the areas where you get a benefit from hand wiring and use a PC board in areas where you get better quality and consistency and performance from a PC board. You know, there's an old debate about whether hand wiring or PC boards are better. Unfortunately, this debate is often conducted without regard to the application. There are certain places where hand wiring is not feasible, and there are certain places where it is, but it's still not ideal. PC boards, like almost anything, come in a huge range of quality. We've chosen to use aerospace grade, which is the very best there is in the world. Ours are very thick and are four layers with one layer of solid copper for grounding. We've also chosen to mount the tube sockets directly to the PC board. And I know that some people may not think this is a great idea, but if done properly, this is absolutely the best way to do it because it minimizes wiring, soldering, and other potentially inconsistencies in manufacturing in this critical area. As I mentioned, our PC board is extremely strong and it can support tremendous pressure. However, it is mounted to many PIM studs on the steel chassis to support it every 1 to 2 inches. There is no cracking, degrading, or flexing when tubes are inserted or removed. Our PC board is also a high temperature circuit board rated at over 200 degrees centigrade, which is nearly 4 times the heat that a 6L 6GC tube can generate at its hottest temperature driven by a Raven audio amplifier. I'm sure that everyone knows that heat rises and does not descend. So you'll notice that the tubes are above the amplifier and PC board. Therefore, the heat rises away from the amplifier and PC board inside the chassis. Two examples where hand wiring is best are connections from the output transformers to the speaker binding posts, which we solder with no breaks or splices. The RCA inputs, along with the volume controls, or another example where we believe where hand wiring is more suitable. Just a couple of examples of how we've engineered wisely, using simplicity and physics, to design a durable and reliable yet elegant amplifier. But ultimately, more importantly than any of this, compare the sound of our Avian Series amplifiers against any other amplifier. You will be astonished. Take advantage of our 45-day in-home trial. Read the terms of the trial period on our website. They're straightforward and simple. There is no better way to make a decision on an amplifier than to hear it in your living room with your music on your speakers. You simply cannot make as an informed decision any other way. There's generally not a long waiting period from the time you order an amp on ravenaudio.com until it's shipped. If you have any other questions, call Raven Audio and feel free to ask for me if you like. I'd love to talk to you.